It's really great to be with you again. Let's begin with prayer. Blessed Lord, who has caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant that we may in such wise read them, hear them, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that by patience and comfort of thy holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our scripture for this week is this. Romans 10, verses 14 to 17. How then will they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching? And how are they to preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news. But they have not all obeyed the gospel, for Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us? So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of God. Do you have beautiful feet? Well, let's just start with this. Hark the voice of Jesus crying, who will go and work today? Fields are white and harvest waiting. Who will bear the sheaves away? Loud and long the master calls you. Remember last week we talked about Jesus calling the disciples and sending them to the lost house of Israel. Rich reward he offers thee. Who will answer gladly calling? Here am I, send me, send me. This is a week before Labor Day. And in that sense, I want to begin this Bible study with these words from John chapter 9, verse 4. We must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. Whoa! The urgency is there. And when we think about reaching out to those who have never heard, those people that St. Paul is talking about, we have to think about what their future is without the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that is why Paul makes such a big point about the importance of people who are willing to go out and share the good news. Now, let me clear up a misquote. There's a quote that says, preach the gospel at all times, use words if necessary. That's attributed to St. Francis of Assisi. St. Francis never said that! Never! What he did say was that those who preach, they need to live a life that is consistent with their message. Now, we know St. Francis is one of the, you know, lover of animals and all this nature kind of stuff, but he was a preacher. According to those who witnessed him and who talked and wrote about his life shortly after he died, he was a preacher probably like Billy Graham or Billy Sunday, somebody who really got the message out. But his life also was consistent with that message. So it's not a matter of just living a nice life, because a nice life will never point people to Jesus. And that is why it is so important that we speak the message. St. Paul, in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, makes it very, very clear when he says again and again that it is the message of Christ's death on the cross. Listen to this. For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with words of eloquent wisdom, lest the cross of Christ be emptied of its power. Then he goes on. For the word of the cross is folly to those who are perishing, but to those who are being saved, it is a power of God. So, if we are going to reach out, and if we want to effectively communicate the gospel to those who have never heard, we have to speak about Jesus. We have to mention the cross. We have to even talk about sin and the problem that sin puts us in. St. Paul says, but they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us? Isaiah, St. Paul knew that often proclaiming the gospel was something that you did not see immediate results from. But then listen to how St. Paul finishes this passage. He says, for faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. And that is my hope for you, that you will be willing to speak the word of Christ so that those who have never heard will hear the saving news of Jesus. And let me close with this. I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story because I know it's true. It satisfies my longing as nothing else can do. And the final verse, I love to tell the story. 'Tis pleasant to repeat. What seems each time I tell it more wonderfully sweet. I love to tell the story, for some have never heard the message of salvation by God's own holy word. We pray, dear Jesus, help me be bold in my proclaiming the good news, the saving news of the gospel to those who have never heard. We pray this in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.